Hey everybody, welcome back to Record-ology. Today we have an interesting one. This is a 10-inch Howard home recording disc, or portable recording disc. Basically, this disc, 10 inches, it was used for recording anything you wanted. So dictation, in this case, this is from my Uncle Bob's, I think a clarinet lesson or recital. It says Bobby on there. So this is pretty interesting stuff. This would have been, I'm going to guess this is probably mid to late 50s. And like I said, 10-inch disc. It is somewhat flexible. It's made out of a kind of a strange material. It's hard to see or hard to say exactly what it is. You'll notice these sprockets are kind of interesting. They're probably particular to the type of lathe that it was recorded on, or record recorder. I have a bad feeling that this is probably recorded at 16 RPM. I don't have a 16 RPM player. So we're going to play with it and see if we can hear anything. But yeah, that's kind of my thought. It also smells to high heaven like magic marker for some reason. I'm not sure why, but it will smell the entire room. The whole room will smell like magic marker if it's not sandwiched in between something. So we're going to start with 33 RPMs and see if we can make out anything on the record. It's also pretty dirty, so I'm going to run this across. It's almost sticky, which I probably should have thought about before I put my brush on there, but let's see what we can find out. True record archaeology here, people. Let's see what we've got. Almost sounds like a bassoon. I definitely think that's actually too slow. So I don't think it's a 16 RPM record. That's good. Let's go ahead and speed it up to 45 and see what we get. A lot of noise. Just for grins, let's try 78. I think that's it. It's a 78. He's pretty good. You'll notice that if you ever put a record on at too slow of a speed, in addition to just being a lower speed, it's also quieter. It's harder to define the actual intended sound from the surface noise when it's at too slow of a speed. When you get up to the proper speed, you'll notice that instrument sort of jumped out and you could hear it a lot better. There's still a whole heck of a lot of surface noise, but we can at least hear what's happening there. All right, guys, that's all for now. Happy hunting, and we'll see you next time.